Hello everyone, wherever you are, glad you're here. I'm not a critic. Today we are finding solutions to the hardest questions in episode 4 of Chernobyl. Let's get into it. Ultimatums can push individuals, having very interesting reactions. As humans, having options and choices can leave a sense of safety. Take that away and the dark in a person comes out. A cold blanket that protects us from feeling fear. We can lose empathy, lose connection, and lose ourselves. A good amount of time has passed since the initial explosion that displaced tens of thousands of people, leaving victims as blistered, bloodied shadows of their former selves. A catastrophe that has never been seen before in the history of mankind. We are introduced to three new characters in Tent 181, Bacho, Pavel, and Garro. Both Garro and Bacho are soldiers in the Red Army, veterans of the Afghanistan War. Pavel, on the other hand, is a civilian, asked by the state to become a liquidator. Bacho reveals that the job at hand is to remove all contaminated animals, feral or domesticated. There is two rules. One, don't point the gun at Bacho, and two, don't let the animal suffer. During a patrol, a moral dilemma presents itself. With a job that needs to be done versus the wrong feeling of taking the life of an animal that is just a victim to the disaster, just like the people. The initial threat of the molten nuclear fuel becoming a thermonuclear explosion has been dealt with. What comes next is an extensive operation to decontaminate the plant and the approximate 100 square kilometers surrounding it. The task with removing the highly radioactive graphite on the roof of the plant will primarily be that of Boris, General Pikhalov, and Valeri. There is three primary sections to focus on. Section 1 that is lethal to a man in 2 hours. Section 2 is lethal in 1 hour. And Section 3, the worst one, is lethal in minutes. A remote control moon rover becomes an option for helping clear the section with the least amount of radiation. Section 3 will be a completely different set of obstacles. With such high levels of radiation, a rover can simply not function. People will inevitably have to be put to the task of removing debris. 90 seconds is all that is permitted. During this sequence, the director did an amazing job, giving viewers the perspective and extreme emotional drive of claustrophobia, fear as the dosimeter goes wild. 90 seconds sounds short, but the scene makes it feel like an eternity. We find out that Valeri is requested to appear at Vienna to give an explanation to the world of what occurred at Chernobyl. The current investigation is showing the flaws of the RBMK reactor. There is a realization that it can occur again and again if not properly dealt with. The episode ends with a crossroad of truth or more lies, of life or death. We are coming close to the end of Chernobyl. I'm excited and I hope you are as well. Thank you again. This is not a critic. Mad love.